26 before the hour on Monday, March 21st. Good morning. It's John and Glenn, Morning Air on Relevant Radio. Does your daughter go to an all-Catholic school? What are the benefits of sending your daughter to an all-girls Catholic school? We're going to look at that in light of the fact that it's Women's History Month in this month of March. Dr. Tracy Weiland is a prominent thought leader on the impact of technology in society, work, and career. She has worked for some of the biggest, Apple, HP, Cisco, the Apollo Group, and she joins us here this morning. First of all, Dr. Tracy, you looked magnificent on CNN the other day.
Oh, thank you, John. I really appreciate it. That's very nice of you.
She is as beautiful as she sounds, guaranteed, if you've not seen Dr. Tracy Weiland on television. So let's actually, you know, you wrote about and have some points about the current generation of kids. And if you've lost track after Generation X, we're up to Generation Z after this. We run out of alphabet. Who are Generation Z?
Well, you know, Generation Z, some refer to as the tail end of the millennials, but they're really their own generations, because generations are sort of scoped by what kinds of experiences that they share. But for the most part, they're born after 1995. They're about 20 years or younger. They're in middle school. They're in high school. Some are in college, and, you know, some might be working as well.
And you have said that they're self-directed, they're more pragmatic. Obviously, they are much more technical. They understand all of the technology that has been such a part of their lives. But when you look at some of those qualities, and if we superimpose those qualities over Generation Z, I'm wondering if Generation Z is going to be a generation of young men and women who are more holy.
Yeah, so there is, you know, so to your point, they're expected to be very different than Generation Y. And some of their experiences is that they've grown up with mixed families. 50% of them actually have hybrid backgrounds. They're, you know, experienced terrorism and cyber attacks and cyclical recession and a number of things that the millennials didn't. So because of that, they're expected to be much more self-directed, much more concerned about their future, much more technical, as you mentioned, but very pragmatic and somewhat entrepreneurial, because if you've watched your parents, the boomers and X's, go in and out of jobs, and you've seen your millennial siblings, you know, go to school and actually not get a job, you know, you have to be much more resourceful about how you plan your career. But yes, there were some interesting blogs out there that I was reading about. They're expected to be a lot more like Pope Francis, and I thought that was a fascinating angle that this author took, that unlike the millennials, the Generation Z will have a much more pragmatic approach to, you know, being Catholic and the religion and their faith. And so, you know, I think from all areas, people are looking at this generation to be very different than the millennials in different ways.
And Dr. Tracy, if we could just look at a subsection of Generation Z, generally kids, men and women under the age of 20, and we look at from, let's say, 14 to 20, and if you just replay some of the video from the March for Life and the zeal, the true zeal for life that young people in their teens and all the way up into their early 20s have for the pro-life movement, I think that perhaps even answers our question or actually confirms your answer about whether or not Generation Z is going to be a holier generation.
Well, you know, it's fascinating. We are going through very interesting times, that since 2004, we have increasingly have more and more young people participating, becoming active in their beliefs, and the numbers are growing. And now my generation, which was X, was a real sloucher generation. We didn't vote. We didn't really do very much. But that has, the tide has sort of changed. So whatever they care about, they are certainly being very proactive about it. So it's very interesting, and I think it's good for us to see these young people just being much more involved than in the past.
So, Dr. Tracy, let's take this big picture of Generation Z and those who are under 20, of course, many of whom are in school. Many may be going to an all-boys Catholic school. I went to an all-boys Catholic school and or an all-girls Catholic school as well. For women who go to same-sex Catholic schools, are they getting a better education? Are they coming out different? Are they becoming more holy? What happens?
So, you know, there was a research study done by UCLA, and what they talked about is graduates from single-sex high schools. in general, have much stronger academic orientations than their co-educational counterparts. And the categories that they looked at was academic engagement, SAT scores, confidence in math, and computer skills. And so I think this just reflects that when you have less distraction, so to speak, and more focus in the classroom, it appears that you have better outcomes. Not to segregate people saying if you're brilliant, you're brilliant, but it's just this comfort value of being with same gender in the classroom.
Did you go to a same-sex Catholic school?
I did. And I had a brother who also went to an all-boys Catholic school. And I found from the female perspective that it was a much better experience for me. One is, you know, I was pretty aware of my girlfriends who were going to all-girls school, that they were constantly distracted by boys. And we weren't, you know, for us, the dating thing was Friday and Saturday nights, not during the week. During the week, we were with our teammates, our classmates, and that was all women, and we were studying and working on school projects and really just dialoguing a lot about school. And I think that sort of helped me later in life to be able to partition when it's time to be academic versus when it's time to be going out on a date.
I went to an old boys Catholic school that was actually a half boarding school and half day student. I was a day student, and those who were boarding were, it was also a minor seminary, so they were in preparation for, you know, perhaps seminary studies after they got out of high school, if they went, you know, if they went on to a college counterpart to this prep school that I went to. So the atmosphere was very much the same as it is at Loyola Academy with Father Pat McGrath, whom we have out, where there was a great focus on prayer as the foundation of the day, not only prayer and service, but also academics as well. Glenn went to public school, so he has a different perspective.
Yes, did Dr. Tracy, did you ever have the feeling you were missing out on anything while you were at that all-girls school?
No, I felt like I had a lot more fun because the women who I grew up with, I'm still friends with now, which is pretty incredible. When you go to an all-girls school, and ours is similar. We had a convent. We called it the nunnery. We were very aware that there were a number of women who were boarding there to become nuns. But you create this unique bond, I think, with other girlfriends. And, you know, they even had you become what they call the older sister program. And so when you start in first grade, that's when I started, someone in the second grade was assigned to you to be your older sister. And her job was to make sure that you were doing okay, and she would, you know, make sure that you're included and making friends. And that whole bond, so I actually am friends still with my peer set, my older sister, and then her older sister, because each class, you know, you have an older sister, and it's pretty amazing the bonds that happen.
What do you think of the uniforms?
So the uniforms were a drag. I'll be the first to tell you that I was very envious of people who went to public school, and they could wear anything that they wanted. They could, you know, wear makeup. They could wear, you know, trendy outfits, because I love fashion. So, you know, we had, you know, blue and green and vests, and, you know, back in those days you had Tams and gloves and knee socks and So I used to break out. I remember with the shoes. excuse me, because I wanted to break out in some way, and shoes was my way of doing it.
Oh, okay. All right. So you didn't get in trouble for the shoes. We were for Holy Name School. It was maroon. And to this day, I've got a little problem with maroon after 8 years of that. And then in high school, it was blue blazers and gray pants. And, you know, you could actually live on the edge if you came in a blue shirt as opposed to a white one. Of course, that was back in the day.
That's right. And then, Glenn, to your point, excuse me. I'm so sorry. Glenn, to your point, the schools are very active in setting up social activities, and I think that was one of the reasons why we didn't feel like we missed out on anything. Every Friday and Saturday night, every Saturday and Sunday day, there were either dances, social sports games, integration with a lot of other boys' schools. So you pretty much were jam-packed from a Friday through a Sunday with nonstop social interactions with you know, other people. So I don't think we felt like we missed out, you know, because you didn't really have to go pursue your own social activities. It was almost like delivered to you, and it was just a matter of just keeping up.
One of the cool things about going to an all-boys high school is that I only made a new pool of friends, but I also had those friends from eighth grade who went on to high school in the public school system. So it was almost like having two networks of friends, which was pretty cool. And those who went on to public high school would always be asking questions about what went on in the Catholic school. There was this sense of fascination from coming out of the Catholic school system in the elementary school system and going on to the public school system. Let's involve our relevant radio audience now at 877-766-3777. Do your children go to a same-sex school, an all-girls Catholic school, an all-boys Catholic school? If so, what's the difference in your children as opposed to those children, children of friends that you may know, whose kids go to public schools? With your children going to an all-boys Catholic school, an all-boys girls, and an all-girls Catholic school, what's the difference for your kids? What are the differences that you see? And also, we can talk about the sacrifices that you have made to send your children to an all-boys or an all-girls Catholic school. 877-766-3777, 877-766-3777. Also, if you went to an all-boys or an all-girls Catholic school, what kind of difference did it make in your life now in the professional realm? 877-766-3777. So we continue with Dr. Tracy Weiland on Monday morning on Morning Air on Relevant Radio.
Your faithful companion.
13 before the hour, Morning Air on Relevant Radio. It's John and Glenn spending time with Dr. Tracy Weiland and talking about the benefits of sending your children to a same-sex Catholic school, your daughters to an all-girls Catholic school, your sons to an all-boys Catholic school. Dr. Tracy Weiland is talking about that this morning, and we'd like to know about your experience. Perhaps you went to an all-boys or an all-girls Catholic school. What kind of edge did that give you in life? Or maybe your sons and daughters are there this morning. We're sharing those stories at 877-766-3777. Lynn is in Wisconsin. Lynn, good morning. Welcome to Morning Air.
Oh, good morning. Yes, I am. I had attended Catholic all-girl high school here in Milwaukee, and my brothers went to the all-boy, and now my daughter's at an all-girl high school, Catholic high school, and my son is at the all-boy Catholic high school, and we love it. I really enjoyed it so much. My brothers enjoyed it so much. And I'm just fortunate enough that my children now can enjoy it as well.
What are some of the things that your children say when they come home from school, from being in that all-Catholic boys' school, that all-Catholic school, the girls' school?
Oh, well, my daughter especially, she enjoys her girlfriends so much. They have such a strong campus ministry program that the girls enjoy. So they're getting this great Catholic education and a great academic education as well. They are able to push themselves. There's no, she enjoys not having the boys around, basically, so they can focus on their girlfriendship. You know, they're focused on their academics. They actually love the uniform because they don't have to think. It's, you know, for some it's a few more minutes of sleep and not having to get all ready to impress someone. And, you know, there's no clothing, you know, to judge, you know, what, because there's such a wide range of
economic. Yeah, good point. Good point. So, I never thought of the extra sleep because you don't have to worry about doing that wardrobe, Lynn. Yep. Thank you very much at 877-766-3777. Best to your kids. And one of the other things that strikes me from Lynn's conversation, Dr. Tracy, is not only that bond, you probably felt that as well, the bond that you have in friendship. As a matter of fact, I saw somebody that I went to a high school with just yesterday, and you know, there is that instant bond, but also a bond, and that's in prayer, because very often we'll run into each other at Mass.
Oh, yes. You know, and most of my girlfriends, I moved west, and most of my girlfriends actually are still where we grew up on the, in the east, and they still go to Mass together, the same church activities together, and they still meet each other at different school events. Now, the school is since closed, but they still actually go out and do things together. So I would agree. The on the academic point, I will say that I think the programs that we had were phenomenal because there was such an emphasis on math and science, as well as you had to go to mass, of course, every morning. But then also we had to learn languages, art, physical education, computer programming. And so it just is a phenomenal environment for academia.
One of the things that I learned from the priests in my prep school is I got to see them as men, as you know, as people, and as a result, you know, even at age, you know, 15, 16, actually, I think it's probably the first time I really appreciated the deep faith life of somebody else. So that was yet another lesson that came out of going to an all-boys Catholic school, an all-girls Catholic school for your sons, daughters. What's it like for them, or perhaps even for you? Let's move on to New Jersey as we spend time with Dr. Tracy Weiland this morning. Maria is joining us this morning at 877-766-3777. Hi, Maria. Welcome to Morning Air.
Hi. I was calling today to comment on that subject. I raised two of my grandchildren, and they were the flip side. They went to regular public school first, and my granddaughter, I noticed little changes in her. We moved from South Jersey to North Jersey, so in North Jersey it was a little tougher in terms of relationships. And so didn't know that she was having all these problems at school with peers. And I made a decision that when she graduated middle school that I would send her to an all-girls Catholic school. And, oh, my God, that saved her. Absolutely saved her. She graduated. She became a true lady, I have to say. It's just so much more than just the education community. Love, care. The programs were for caring about other people, not just taking the emphasis off self. And it was a wonderful, wonderful thing. She's recently graduated from university, and she thanks me all the time, even though, you know, there's a lot of things that people don't talk about. I mean, they got in trouble, too, like you do. They used to sneak out and things like that from the classroom, which was, but it was, all in all, it changed our life because it changed her life. And she became a caring, loving young lady who is today married and is doing all the right things.
Ah, that's beautiful, Maria. One of the things that strikes me from Maria's comments, Dr. Tracy, is something that I don't think we've talked about directly. We've talked about the academic benefits of an all-girls Catholic and all-boys Catholic school, the spiritual benefits. But in Maria's answer about her granddaughter, here is a young woman who's gotten great confidence coming out of the Catholic school system.
Yes, and actually to her point, I would absolutely agree with that. You know, I had only women teachers. So they were the leaders. And so I found that the school instilled us in a very young age that women are leaders. There's confidence through achievement and confidence through the ability to team and work with your peers. And I think it's great that she observed the need to move her granddaughter and saw the improved outcomes. And that, you know, a lot of the research does suggest that because once, you know, you don't have a lot of those distractions. You don't have male teachers who might call on a male student. Well, you have, you know, over a female student. You have female teachers. You have only female classmates. And so basically, you know, there aren't added extras in there that could, you know, dissuade someone or promote someone over someone else. So I would absolutely agree with her. I was very confident, and I noticed it in college, that as a freshman, I was uniquely much more confident than the other women on campus. And I did go to a co-ed college, and I was surprised at how insecure many of the young women were coming in freshman year. And I think it's very important to have confidence in college, because if you're in my case where I went away, you know, there could be a lot of stuff can happen. And so you really have to have a good grounding. And I felt that the school really provided a very good grounding And I could always reach out to my girlfriends if there were questions I had or if I was confused about something. So I would agree.
That's a good point, because you probably don't understand how you matured in that environment until, as I went away from a very small school to a very big co-ed school in a big city, how that maturity and those lessons that were given to me by the priests in my high school, that they serve you well. Maria, thank you very much. Let's move on to Kim in Wisconsin at 877-766-3777 with Dr. Tracy Weiland and the benefits of sending your son or daughter to a Catholic school. And Kim in Wisconsin, good morning. Welcome.
Hi, good morning. I went to a wonderful Catholic school on Milwaukee's lakefront, and it was beautiful. And spiritually, I think I grew tremendously. But one of the regrets I have is that the sisters didn't encourage holy orders. And since, I have to say, I've been divorced a couple of times, and life has been really hard. And I still have that longing.
Mm-hmm.
And I just would encourage the schools to help us in that regard.
That's a good point. That's a good point, because I remember being in seventh and eighth grade in elementary school, and this is in the late 60s, where we had priests come in and talk about vocations. And obviously, I think you think about it, and most young Catholic men probably still do at that point. But we didn't have that same thing. It's interesting you mentioned it. I never thought of it until now, Kim. We did not have that in high school, yet the priests in high school were just wonderful witnesses of the joy of becoming a priest and the joy of becoming a man, not only in society, but a man for God. But that's an interesting point, Kim. What would you think about that, Dr. Tracy? Did you have anybody come in to your all-girls Catholic high school and talk about holy orders?
That is a very interesting point. Not formally. We did have, we had to do service, whether it was candy stripers or going over to visit and tour the convent, and the convent was very close. And so my sense is that if you had an interest in it, that it probably would have come out there. You have to remember, many of us have had people who were either priests or nuns in our family, and that's pretty typical growing up on the East Coast, Irish families, Polish families, mm-hmm. Italian families. So we were constantly surrounded with relatives who were, either priests or nuns or somehow,
Sure.
So I think if, because we had so much of that in our lives, I think if that conversation was going to happen, it probably would have happened with a family member and then brought to the school's attention.
Sure.
But it's a very good point.
A great conversation this morning with Dr. Tracy Weiland and the benefits of sending your son or daughter to an Catholic school, especially in the secondary education. TracyWeiland.com on the World Wide Web. Thank you, Dr. Tracy. Talk to you again soon in a minute before the hour on Morning Air on Relevant Radio.